Get ready for Math Dominus's Godzillathon! Godzilla Planet of the Monsters. After the success of Shin Godzilla, Toho announced an anime trilogy for Godzilla. Now, this wouldn't be the first time that Godzilla has appeared in the animation medium. However, this is the first time that they made a fully fledged CGI movie featuring Godzilla. So, let's think about this for a second. Live action Godzilla has limitations because not only does reality has limitations, but also practical effects and the suit has limitations. Pretty much everything live action has limitations. However, with animation, there are no limits, so the possibilities on where they could have taken this trilogy are endless, and yet the best way to describe these movies are missed opportunity. Oh boy, I got a lot of problems with the first movie. So, where do I even start? I guess we could start with the concept. The concept of this movie is that kaijus have taken over the planet and humanity has abandoned Earth because of it. Now, that's not a bad concept. However, in execution, the whole kaiju taking over the planet thing is just a backstory. And nothing more than just a backstory, it then picks off where humanity left off, abandoning Earth, and then going back to take it back. So, let me ask you this. Wouldn't it make it more sense if, you know, the first movie was about the rise of the planet of the kaiju, and then the second movie would be taking back Earth? No? That doesn't make any sense. Come on, that perfectly makes a lot of sense. The point is, they definitely missed an opportunity to introduce the whole kaijus taking over the planet. I would have loved to see that movie, but unfortunately that movie doesn't exist, so we're just gonna have to go by the plot that this movie gives us. So what about the plot itself? Is it any good? Well, the entire plot of this movie is the fact that they're trying to kill Godzilla. Now, that simple, you know, simple plot, which should probably take like, you know, 30 minutes at most, is stretched for an hour. This movie is so slow, it kind of gets boring halfway through because all it is they're just trying to extend this movie from the concept of the fact that they're trying to kill Godzilla and just make an entire movie out of it by stretching it, and it's just very boring. It makes the movie slow paced than it should be, and it just kind of boggles me that this is the first movie in the trilogy. The plot is just really bad. But, I know what you're going to say. What about the characters? Even if the plot is bad, does the movie have strong characters? Well, no. Haruro, the main protagonist, is just your average angry anime guy. Mephius, the only other interesting character, is just kind of this religious prophet who I'm pretty sure is gay. And the rest? I don't even remember their names. I just remember the girl, the scientist, the council. I just remember them by titles, not actual names. So, bad plot, missed opportunity of a concept, and of course, bad characters. But what about Godzilla himself? Well, Godzilla himself is actually kind of good in this movie. They portray him as a force of nature, how nature's wrath is very intimidating. Also, they made Godzilla a plant in this movie. So does this mean Godzilla and Biollante had insects? Okay, I'm taking this too far. So Godzilla himself isn't that bad, but it's called Planet of the Monsters. Where are the other monsters? I just see Servum, which are these weird dragon snake things. That's the best way to describe this movie. Missed opportunity. And overall, it's just a bad Godzilla movie. And it really is just a missed opportunity. Now keep in mind, this is just the first in the trilogy. And oh boy, it gets worse. It really, really gets worse.